The bill looks to give people who were convicted with non-unanimous juries another chance at a new trial or parole options. But the bill did not come to a vote today because Representative Gaines says that he wants to wait for the Supreme Court decision, but others are pushing him to move forward anyways. Non-unanimous juries were born in the late 1800s and seen as a way to better convict people of color to be used for prisoner leasing. People could be found guilty with a 10-2 vote of a jury, and the practice was found to be unconstitutional by the Supreme Court. And the people of Louisiana voted in 2018 to repeal the policy, and this bill would allow a retroactive aspect of the repeal.
This is to protect them, and if justice is to be fair, if justice is to prevail, it has to be applied uniformly and universally.
While there was no opposition in the committee hearing, there is a concern that allowing the 1,500 people convicted under these juries a chance of a new trial could overwhelm the already bogged down court system.
But we should not reject retroactive relief through a fear that we will produce a tsunami of litigation. We have to address legally sanctioned racism in our criminal justice system, and that's the only way we can make progress.
A case in the U.S. Supreme Court involving a Louisiana man is being heard now. He is asking for the retroactive part of the law to apply to him, and Representative Gaines voluntarily deferred his bill to wait for the Supreme Court decision on that case. But some lawmakers say there is enough support to pass the law now.
I'm certainly going to have some conversations with Representative Gaines. I don't want to wait on the Supreme Court. You know, I was elected to enact policy. It's clear the voters of the state of Louisiana want us to reverse this policy. We all know the history of this policy. I don't necessarily subscribe to the notion that I need the Supreme Court to tell me how to do my job.
Even if the court does not support retroactivity, the state can still pass its own law. The bill was still voluntarily deferred, waiting for the Supreme Court decision, but there is a chance that it could still come to a vote this session. At the Capitol for your local election headquarters, I'm Shannon Hecht.